Today video lesson is Pacinia. Pacinia belongs to class Pacciniaceae and the family of Pacinia. Pacinia belongs to class Teleomycetes and the family Pacciniaceae and the genus Pacinia. So, before going to the topic, we are discussed a few lines about Basidiomycotina. So, Basidiomycotina members are commonly called club fungi, and these Basidiomycotina members mainly saprophytes. A few members are parasites on plants, for example, rust and smuts, these are parasitic fungus on plants. So, Basidiomycotina vegetative plant body is made up of mycelia. Mycelia is nothing but a group of hyphae is called mycelia. Hyphae is a singular tubular structure that is called hyphae. It means a group of hyphae is fused and forms a specialized structure that is called mycelium. So, the Basidiomycotina members vegetative plant body is mycelium. So, mycelium is made up of a group of hyphal cells. Hyphae is septate or aseptate. A few members are septate. Septa is nothing but formation of a cross wall between the cells, that is called septa. If the septa is present, that cells are called septate, and the septa is absent, that cells are called aseptate. In Basidiomycotina members, cells are septate mycelium. The plant body, which is mycelia, the cell components are protoplasm and the cell wall, and all the cell organelles are present in their structure. Protoplasm, the cell wall is made up of chitin and glucan. The reproduction in Basidiomycotina vegetatively, asexually and sexually. Vegetatively by fragmentation. Fragmentation is nothing but parental thallus breaks away several pieces, and each piece is known as fragment. These fragments are further developed and produce new mycelium, that is one type of vegetative reproduction. So, vegetative reproduction by fragmentation. Asexual reproduction by spores like basidiospores, acidiospores, teletospores, these are asexual spores. And the sexual reproduction by plasmogamy. Plasmogamy is nothing but fusion of two different strains, that is called plasmogamy. Now, Pacinia belongs to Basidiomycotina member and the family of Pacciniaceae. So, Pacinia is an obligate parasitic member. So, this Pacinia, it is distributed cosmopolitan in nature. So, Pacinia classification, kingdom Mycota and the division Eumycota, subdivision Basidiomycota and the class Teleomycetes, order Uridinales, family Pacciniaceae and the genus Pacinia. So, these Pacinia distribution and habitat. Pacinia is a fungus and it is an obligate parasite. It included the class Basidiomycetes and the family of Pucciniaceae. The Pucciniia name was given by T. Pucciniia, who an Italian botanist. The Pucciniia is represented by 147 species, and these are distributed throughout the world. The Pucciniia is a very large genus with about 1800 species. In that, in our India, 147 species are reported. The major Pucciniia members are Pucciniia graminis and the Pucciniia recondita and the Pucciniia striformis. Pucciniia graminis, and it is also called wheat rust or stem rust. Pucciniia recondita, it is also called brown rust or leaf rust. And the third one, Pucciniia striformis, it is also called stripe rust or yellow rust. The Pucciniia species causes rust diseases in cereal crops like wheat, oats and maize. So, Pucciniia life cycle, which is completed by two hosts. One is the stem rust and the second one barberry leaf. So, Pucciniia enter the life cycle, which is completed two host cells. The first one is wheat and the second one is barberry plant. So, wheat botanical name Triticum aestivum, barberry plant botanical name Berberis vulgaris. So, Pucciniia an obligate parasite. So, life cycle of Pucciniia, which is completed by two host cells, one is the wheat and the second one barberry leaf. The cell structure of Pucciniia. Pucciniia cells are multicellular organism. It means Pucciniia is a mycelial organism. So, mycelia is formed a group of intercellular hyphae, and the cell wall is made up of chitin and glucan materials. So, Pucciniia infected plants are mainly wheat and barberry. The reproduction, the Pucciniia reproduction, it is the macrolytic cycle. It means it is the complex cycle of Pucciniia. Entire the Pucciniia life cycle, which is completed on two hosts, one is the wheat and second one barberry. Entire its life cycle, which is produces five types of spores. Pucciniia enter the life cycle, which is completed by two host cells and five types of spores. And the spores are mainly iridiospores, teletospores, basidiospores, pycnidiospores and acidiospores. First of all, iridiospores. Iridiospores are binucleated unicellular stalked spores that are called iridiospores. So, iridiospores are produced by acidiospores. So, acidiospores, which are produced on the alternative host, that is barberry plant. Now, iridiospores are fall on the wheat plants. Now, these are enter into the host through the stomata. Now, iridiospores, single cell, unicellular, binucleated spores that are iridiospores. So iridiospores developing on the primary host tissue, that is wheat cells. Now iridiospores liberated out, and these are carried out by wind and fall on fresh wheat plants. They infected this disease. So the iridiospores are fall on the wheat plant. They are taking 6 to 10 days remaining. These are germinate and produce a number of iridiospores. So between the resting period, this is called resting spores, and the iridiospores are formed in the wheat plants in early summer. In early summer stage, the iridiospores are infected the wheat plants. The second one, teletospores. Teletospores, the same dikaryotic mycelium which produces a number of iridiospores in early summer, the same type dikaryotic mycelium which is produces a number of spores in winter season. That's why these spores are called winter spores. But in early summer, the iridiospores are liberated out, and these are carried out by wind and fall on a suitable substratum, and the remaining produces iridiospores. But teletospores are, these are not remaining spores. It means in winter season, teletospores are formed. The third one, basidiospores. Basidiospores are formed on the alternative host, that is barberry plant. Basidiospores are formed on a cylindrical tubular like structure, that is called stigmata. It means basidiospores are formed on the tips of stigmata. The basidiospores are also binucleated unicellular cells. Binucleated unicellular cells, that is basidiospores. So these basidiospores, which is produced by two types of strains, that is plus strain and minus strain. Basidiospores undergoes to meiotic division and forms haploidic spores. So these spores are, two spores are plus strains and remaining two spores are minus strains. Fourth one, acidiospores. Acidiospores are formed on barberry plant, and the acidiospores also binucleated unicellular members. Acidiospores are formed on the leaf surface, upper surface and lower surface of barberry plant leaf. So these are acidiospores. And the last one, pycnidiospores. Pycnidiospores, so these are also binucleated unicellular members, but pycnidiospores and acidiospores are formed monokaryotic mycelium. The Puccinia life cycle, entire the life cycle, which is completed by five spores, that iridiospores, teletospores and basidiospores are formed, and these three types of spores produced by dikaryotic mycelia, but pycnidiospores एंड एसिडियोस्पोर्स आर प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय मोनोकैरियोटिक माइसीलिया. सो डिफरेंस बिटवीन मोनोकैरियोटिक एंड बाइकैरियोटिक माइसीलिया. मोनोकैरियोटिक माइसीलिया इज नथिंग बट सिंगल न्यूक्लियस विच इज प्रेजेंट एंड द मोनोकैरियोटिक माइसीलियम इज शॉर्ट लिव्ड माइसीलियम. बट द डाइकैरियोटिक माइसीलियम इज ए टू न्यूक्लियस विच इज फ्यूज्ड, दट इज बाइन्यूक्लिएटेड माइसीलियम एंड यूनिसेल्युलर एंड इट इज लॉन्ग स्टेज. दट इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन डाइकैरियोटिक माइसीलियम एंड मोनोकैरियोटिक माइसीलियम. एंटायर द लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ पक्सिनिया विच इज कंप्लीटेड बाय फाइव स्टेजेस, इरिडियोस्पोर्स एंड द सेकंड वन टेलिटोस्पोर्स एंड द थर्ड वन बेसिडियोस्पोर्स एंड द फोर्थ वन पिक्निडियोस्पोर्स एंड द फिफ्थ वन एसिडियोस्पोर्स. इट मीन्स लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ पक्सिनिया. सो पक्सिनिया लाइफ साइकिल विच इज कंप्लीटेड बाय टू होस्ट सेल्स, वन इज द वीट प्लांट एंड द सेकंड वन बार्बरी प्लांट. पक्सिनिया इट इज एन ऑब्लिगेटिक पैरासाइट्स एंड द ऑब्लिगेटिक पैरासाइट्स मीन्स एंटायर द लाइफ साइकिल विच इज कंप्लीटेड डिपेंड अपॉन होस्ट. सो पक्सिनिया लाइफ साइकिल इज कंप्लीटेड बाय टू होस्ट, दे आर वीट एंड रस्ट. ऑब्लिगेटिक पैरासाइट्स आर पक्सिनिया एंड अगारिकस एंड यूस्टिलागो. दीज आर बेसिडियो माइकोटिना मेंबर्स एंड दीज बेसिडियो माइकोटिना मेंबर्स आर ऑब्लिगेट पैरासाइट्स इन प्लांट्स लाइक फेंस एंड जिम्नोस्पर्मिक प्लांट्स. सो डाइकैरियोटिक माइसीलियम विच इज प्रोड्यूस्ड टू टाइप्स ऑफ माइसीलिया. सो माइसीलियम विच इज प्रोड्यूस्ड टू टाइप्स, वन इज द मोनोकैरियोटिक माइसीलिया एंड डाइकैरियोटिक माइसीलिया. सो मोनोकैरियोटिक माइसीलिया एंड डाइकैरियोटिक माइसीलिया, दीज बोथ आर प्रेजेंट इन पक्सिनिया लाइफ साइकिल. इफ सपोज डाइकैरियोटिक माइसीलियम विच इज प्रोड्यूस्ड ए नंबर ऑफ यूडियोस्पोर्स, टेलिटोस्पोर्स एंड बेसिडियोस्पोर्स ऑन द प्राइमरी होस्ट टिश्यू ऑफ वीट, बट मोनोकैरियोटिक माइसीलियम विच इज प्रोड्यूस्ड पिक्निडियोस्पोर्स एंड एसिडियोस्पोर्स ऑन अल्टरनेटिव होस्ट दट इज बार्बरी प्लांट. यूरिडियोस्पोर्स एंड टेलिटोस्पोर्स एंड बेसिडियोस्पोर्स आर डाइकैरियोटिक माइसीलियम. डाइकैरियोटिक माइसीलियम प्रेजेंट ऑन द प्राइमरी होस्ट. द मोनोकैरियोटिक माइसीलियम विच इज प्रेजेंट ऑन द अल्टरनेटिव होस्ट दट इज वीट. सो एंटायर द लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ पक्सिनिया कंप्लीटेड बाय फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ स्पोर्स, स्टार्टिंग प्राइमरी होस्ट स्टार्ट्स विथ यूरिडियोस्पोर्स एंड द अल्टरनेटिव होस्ट एंड्स विथ एसिडियोस्पोर्स. नाउ द एसिडियोस्पोर्स फॉल ऑन द primary host and they produce a number of iridiospores. That is main character of Pacsinia. Means entire the life cycle which is completed by two host, primary host starts with iridiospores and the secondary host barberry leaf ends with acidiospores. In that five types of spores, iridiospores germinate and produce a number of iridospores, and these iridospores fall on the infected fresh wheat plants. They remain produce a number of iridospores, but telutospores, dikaryotic mycelium produces telutospores, but these telutospores are dormant in the soil. It means they do not infect the leaves. That is main difference between iridospores and telutospores. So, the iridospores are produced in early summer and the telutospores are produced in winter season. So, the telutospores are also called winter spores. Puccinia infected a number of cereal crops and crop diseases in wheat, oats. These are Puccinia infected plants. So, Puccinia, a number of species are present in Puccinia. In our India, major species of Puccinia are Puccinia graminis and Puccinia recondita and Puccinia striformis. These are main infected crop diseases. So, Puccinia infect plant parts like stems and leaves. Suppose Puccinia stem rust on wheat plant. Puccinia rust, reddish brown color rust are formed on the wheat stems, and these are infected entire the plant. And the second one, barberry leaf. A few members of Puccinia infected barberry leaves. So, Puccinia spores enter into the leaf through the stoma, and the cells are repeated divisions and forms a number of spores in the leaves. So, Puccinia is a rust fungi which produces number of spores, and the spores infect the plants. Puccinia members are an obligate intracellular parasitic, and the Puccinia belongs to class Teleomycetes and the family of Puccinaceae.